everybody. Happy Friday. Yay, it is finally the end of the week. And oh, by the way, it's also Valentine's Day.
Yes, happy Valentine's Day to you. I'm Art Rascone, and along with Melanie Lawson. And the best thing about today's show is it is the final one of the week.
Yeah.
Here we are Friday.
There's a lot of truth to that.
We're going to be selling. We're going to be getting into the weekend tomorrow. We have a lot going on. Of course, today's Valentine's Day. So what better way to say I love you than with a lock? We're going to show you a bridge in Houston that is a favorite spot for couples to put a lock.
Yeah, we also have a couple of mixologists visiting the newsroom today. They're showing us how to make some really tasty, really lovely Valentine's Day drinks.
Yeah, and XFL Commissioner Oliver Luck and Roughnecks President Brian Cooper are also here to talk about what they've learned since the season began.
But we do want to begin with the news this morning, and some pretty serious stuff to start off with. One of two people killed in this morning's crash in Northeast Harris County is now being identified as a local gospel star, LaTanya Earle. Two vehicles collided head-on at Old Humble Road. Deputies say one of the drivers was trying to avoid some wet cement that had spilled into the road, but the result of that, two people are killed. Just a horrible accident.
Really, really sad. Especially for the congregation of that gospel singer as well. No sign of the driver who nearly ran over an officer in West University, but police have his passenger. Police say they had just pulled up to the two men when the driver just suddenly sped off. The two jumped out and ran. After a search involving dogs, canines, and drones, police arrested the passenger.
Well, the Astros are coming clean, but some really not happy with their apology for the sign-stealing scandal. Media and fans all over the country have been criticizing the team online for what they're calling an insincere and inadequate response. A lot of people saying it's just too little, too late, and it didn't sound like they meant it at all. A.J. Hinch and Jeff Luhnow were fired over the scandal, but you may remember no players were punished, although we have heard from several of the players about their own personal apologies. And still talking about sports, the Roughnecks are playing the Battle Hawks this coming Sunday.
Yeah, that's exciting. The Roughnecks, as you know, they're the local team right here in Houston, XFL, and they've already had a game or two. But this comes after the league announced that right here in Houston, they're going to be holding the championship game. They're going to be playing, the very first championship game, playing right there on where the Roughnecks play, the TDECU Stadium. Let's go to sports producer Joe Gleason. Joe?
Hey, Art. Melanie, how are you guys doing this afternoon? Got some special guests in studio today. XFL Commissioner Oliver Luck and Roughnecks President Brian Michael Cooper join us today. Talk a little XFL. Oliver, you made an exciting announcement, not only for the league, but also for the city yesterday, announcing Houston is the destination for the first XFL championship. What went into the decision?
Well, we all know that Houston's an unbelievable football town, and people rally around big events, you know, championship events, be it Super Bowl or Final Four, NBA All-Star Game. So this was a good decision by us, I think, but a great decision for the Harris County, Houston area. Our championship game at University of Houston, TDECU Stadium, April 26, 2 p.m., live on ESPN. It's going to be a great game. We can't, of course, guarantee that the Roughnecks will be in that game. It'll be the two best teams, but the way the Roughnecks are playing, there might be a pretty good shot there in that game. So we couldn't be happier based on all the support that we've received so far from this great city.
Yeah, you can't guarantee it, but Brian, you guarantee it.
Hey, I'll be Joe Namath right now, and absolutely. Look, we hope to be there on April 26th, so no doubt.
I got to think you were pretty pleased with the week one, the support that the city came out. What was your overall impression of week one for the Roughnecks?
It was just fantastic. We about 3 hours before kickoff, we got a sense of how special it was going to be. We went out to the tailgate lot, and it was already going. It was the tents all back to the back of the lot. Everybody was out grilling and having a great time, and we knew at that point it was like it's going to be a special day. And the fans just came, and they were loud. They were there. They were excited. The stadium was just electric. It was really a fun time.
It really was. I was down on the field and I didn't know what to expect covering NFL games, college games, high school games. And there was really a different sense in that stadium, a really electric place. Oliver, how did the league see Houston's opening week and the league's opening week?
So I was in D.C. where we had the inaugural game, the D.C. Defenders playing the Seattle Dragons. Great, up-tempo, fast-paced game, scored a bunch of points in that game. I thought good, crisp quarterback play. As soon as that game was over, I jumped in to a suite to watch the broadcast of the Roughnecks game, Fox Live out of TDECU Stadium. And I kind of wished I had been here because the atmosphere was awesome, as we said. P.J. Walker played incredibly well. We think overall it was a really good first weekend. It's a small sample size, only four games, but of course you always want to start strong. You only have one chance to make a first impression, as the old saying goes. So all in all, I think we were very pleased. Our TV ratings were solid. You know, game on ABC, game on ESPN, couple of games on Fox. So we just now have to maintain a relatively high level as we go through the season.
I was going to say, Brian, I mean, you set the bar. You always want to go up over the bar, but the St. Louis Battlehawks are coming in town.
They're coming.
Sunday, 5 p.m. at TDECU Stadium. Kind of what can fans expect? Give us an idea of what they can do if they weren't able to make it to the home opener.
On Sunday afternoon, it's first responders salute. So we're going to have a lot of area first responders out, and we're going to be honoring them. But we're going to have the fan plaza as well with food trucks and the bands out there. We're going to have the tailgate lot. I mean, I think if you did not experience that last week, you must come out for that. I mean, the tailgating was incredible. So we're going to have that, and we're going to have a great game, and we're going to have a great atmosphere inside the stadium. We're upping some of our things that we're doing on the concession and merchandise side. We've heard from the fans, and we recognize that, and so we're making moves there. And it's just going to, we're going to make sure that everyone has an incredible fan experience.
And the best thing about it, sorry to interrupt, the best thing about it, Joe, is that tickets are being sold for $20.
Indeed.
For 20 bucks, you can get a great seat in a great stadium and really enjoy 3 hours of professional football.
Exactly.
And lastly, ABC13 will have next week's game against Tampa Bay Vipers, so we're looking forward to that. This week you can see the New York Guardians against the D.C. Defenders on ABC Saturday at 1, and Dallas Renegades and the L.A. Wildcats on ABC 13 Sunday at 2. Gentlemen, thank you very much, and continued success with the XFL. Back to you guys in the newsroom, Mel.
All right, Joe. Thank you so much. Oliver and Brian there. It really is pretty exciting. You can take your whole family for really the cost of a movie or something.
Right, $25 or so. TDECU Stadium, a terrific place to watch the game as well. All right, good luck, Roughnecks, in their next upcoming game. Now, we found the perfect place to take your Valentine's Day selfie.
That's for Jerry there. There's a bridge that goes over Allen Parkway that has a fabulous view of downtown. Look at this. This is so gorgeous. It also has all of these. These are hundreds of locks left by couples from all over the city as a symbol of their everlasting love. So really kind of a nice place to stop by on Valentine's Day. Very romantic.
That is cool. Maybe I'll take my wife there. Put a lock up there.
Definitely, since we put our lock on the bridge, there have been a lot more people coming down here and adding to the whole collection.
There was probably, I could say, 30 locks. It wasn't that filled. And now seeing all these names and all these dates on it, just so beautiful and heartwarming, knowing that people are actually as in love with this location as we are.
Very cool.
Yeah, it really is a sweet thing to do on Valentine's Day. Yeah, just for the cost of a lock, by the way.
Yep. And that, by the way, is just right over Allen Parkway, right?
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Looking towards downtown. And you can watch all of our localish stories on ABC13.com. We've got a lot of great stories from all over.
We do. All right. Speaking of Valentine's Day, let's get over to Chelsea now and talk about what she has in store for Valentine's Day. Chelsea?
All right. Well, first things first, Art, here's your digital deal of the day. We found this pop-up spaceship tent for just 39% off. You can get it for $21.49. All the details are over on ABC13.com. I also have the link shared for you over on my social media pages, Chelsea ABC13. Well, guys, we have some special guests joining us, more special guests joining us here on the midday for this Valentine's Day. Of course, we're whipping up some love potion drinks. I have Jody joining me as well as Tara from Wholesome Kitchen.
Tara.
Tara. Tara. Tara. Tara. Sarah. There we go. From Wholesome Kitchen and Bar. So, Jody, we're going to start with you. What have you whipped up here?
Well, first of all, I want to say happy Valentine's to all you ladies out there. And we've whipped up a couple of drinks that I think is really suiting for a special day like today. First, we have our, we'll go with our, well, so this is going to be our...
I am just drawing a blank now, so on my drink.
So basically, this is called our French Kiss Float.
Okay.
And what it is basically, it's a house-made sorbet that our Chef Tien makes in-house.
Oh,
and
yum.
Basically, we just float it with Veuve Clicquot sparkling rosé. And you can do this at home. You can just go to any of your local grocers and pick up a bottle of raspberry sorbet and then go to your local liquor store or wherever and pick up a bottle of Veuve Clicquot sparkling rosé.
Yum. So this is a fairly easy drink to make, but for those people who, you know, just want to be treated special on this Valentine's Day, Tara, tell us a little bit about y'all's Valentine's menu you have going on.
So we are currently offering a four-course Valentine's Day menu. It comes with a starter, a soup or a salad. Entree options include fettuccine di mar, an 8-ounce filet with also the option to add on a lobster tail.
Oh, yum!
And for dessert, we are offering red velvet cake and bananas Foster.
Oh, all of this sounds so delicious. Of course, Jody, these drinks will be served up as well for everyone to enjoy.
Right. This is one of our more popular drinks that we do serve pretty much year-round. It's basically a spritzer-style drink, wine cooler. We call it basically a Porto Passion, which is made with port wine, has a little bit of peach, blood orange, just really nice fruitful flavors in there. And we just top it off with rosé wine as well. So,
yum.
Yeah, very delicious, refreshing drink.
Everyone's going to have roses at their home, probably some sort of flower. You could just throw that into your drink
Absolutely.
As well. Jerry, I think Jerry likes that idea. Awesome. And Tara, tell us where you guys are located.
We are located in Redemption Square off of Beltway 8 and Lake Park, Lake Houston Parkway.
Awesome. Okay, guys. Well, cheers. Thank you so much for joining us on The Midday. Happy Friday. Happy Valentine's Day. Be safe. Be blessed. See you Monday.